think we're very much confident that we could beat Ecuador in this home and away. In spite of the altitude going and play in Ecuador, I think we're positive. We're going to get the training in Mexico City, and we're just, you know, we're confident that we can still come home with this World Cup qualification for Trinidad.
How would you sum up the entire tournament?
One word to describe this entire tournament, I would say can't. You know, each game, it was different. We had a different mindset, but we all went out there and played with hearts, and we fought for Trinidad and Tobago and for each other.
As I said, most importantly, the dream is still alive. You know, we just have to take advantage of the opportunity this time around and go there and do our best like we've done in the CONCACAF tournament. And I think we have what it takes. I think the preparation, I think the Honourable Minister would do his best to get us the best preparation we can get for this first game on the 8th coming up here.
How would you sum up this entire 3-week experience?
You know what? I mean, it's been a fantastic experience, especially with these young ladies, you know, become sisters on this tournament. And I think we give everything that we could have given on that field, every time we stepped on that field. And for us, that's all we can ask of ourselves, and we have no regrets.
The last week was a good experience for me, playing all of the top teams in CONCACAF. It was a great performance of my team, and I was glad to be part of this opportunity.
And what are your hopes? Obviously, you think that we're still very much in it and looking ahead to the Ecuador playoffs?
Yes, we still need. The dream's still alive. Just have to go out and execute what is the game plan and be victorious.
TNT forward, Ahkeela Mollon. Ahkeela, you're obviously back home now and we're still very much in the dream. Is still alive? How do you feel?
I feel good about it.
Yeah.
I think we were able to go out there and show the world what Trinidad Tobago female footballers is all about. And going into the Ecuador game is just a moment of excitement. Just building off of the momentum of how we played well in the recently concluded CONCACAF tournament. So for us now, it's just basically keeping our composure and staying focused and getting as much preparation as we can for leading up to the first game in November.
Right, your combination with Kenya seemed to have worked, especially during the group phase. How you felt about that, especially having, I mean, you all would have played before in the past, but you came into this team just mere days before the tournament. How you felt about that?
Yeah, well, this is the first time I played the national team in 3 years, so for me, coming and linking up with Kenya like that is truly amazing. I know for me, once I received the ball on the right side, I know with her speed and her ability, she's always going to be breaking into goal. So for me, it's just delivering a good ball in order for her to execute it. And she has done 3 headers off of my 3 crosses, and for that, I'm proud about.
What has the response been like from your peers in Sweden, where you play? Obviously, they've been following you. What has the feedback been like?
Oh, they're so excited. Well, it's 6 hours time difference, so they actually just wake up early in the morning and take in the games, and they were like, how do you guys run so fast? They're just fascinated about our athleticism, how we carry about ourselves on the field, and they're very impressed. They're very, very
And now looking ahead to Ecuador, everything to play for in these 2 games.
Looking forward to Ecuador, I'm so excited. I'm so excited for November 8th, and I'm more so excited to play in front of a home crowd, and if it's God's will, and I believe it is, then we'll bring it home December 2nd.
I have to pay more.